Alifia, can we start here? The Everything Pain portfolio. I mean, is anything working this year in 2022?
I mean, you talked about uncertainty on the political front just as much in the markets, right? I mean, there's three themes that everyone's talking about, and it used to be short-term themes. Now it's going to affect the portfolio for the next 2, 3, 4 years, right? Slowing global economy, monetary tightening and inflation, and the impact from the Ukraine-Russia war. Nothing's been resolved there. We're still in the same. Oil, $100, $105, $95, doesn't matter.
You and Afshani are too young to remember 78, 79 and the glory of the bond bear market then. You people advise on quiet money. You have never seen bond losses like this. How does quiet money recover in bonds? Price up, yield down. What is the actual mechanism to do that?
Well, you know, it's very interesting. And so thank you for calling me so young, first of all. I appreciate that. I don't know if some of my colleagues will be as flattered. I think a lot of us can remember some of the pain points in the markets, though. And I think one of the interesting things about the fixed income markets today is we're looking very, very closely at where is the 10-year yield going to go, what timeline do we have, and how do we start to manage our fixed income
exposure. So you're gauging your bond recovery institutionally off full faith and credit.
Yes, for now. We haven't started to see a ton of signs of distress, but there are a lot of indices that we're looking at, a lot of metrics we're looking at to see if the corporate bond market is starting to crack.
How would you describe it? We've taken out the wides of late 2018, about 550 through those levels. That was enough for this Federal Reserve back then to pivot. Clearly different world, different inflation level. How do you judge what is stressful this time compared to what was stressful then?
Yeah, well, you know, we have the benefit of investing in a lot of debt financing types of strategies, right? So we're looking to see what is the underwriting? Has it loosened? We're looking to see where will the cracks be? We're looking at the high yield market. I mean, spreads have widened over 500 basis points, right, in the last few months. We're looking to see where are the relative opportunities and are you getting paid for that risk? There's going to be risk in the market, right? But defaults would have to double if we wanted to see a huge loss in our high yield portfolio. So is it the right time to start stepping in? I'm not saying we're doing anything right now. I think it's a wait and see moment. And I think we're going to have to wait and see where things, you know, shake out. But there are pockets of opportunity that we are starting to see. And I don't think we have to worry as much about credit risk in our fixed income portfolio as we do about duration management.
What are you waiting for? Talk to me about what you're waiting for. You stress we're not doing anything right now. Why not?
Inflation. I think it's been clear by the Fed that that is their target. They're looking at inflation and everything's hinging around inflation and consumer demand is going to hinge around inflation. We have a huge earnings season coming up, right? I mean, July is going to be a bellwether of inflation expectations, what are companies seeing, what are corporates pricing in. Q1 was pretty good. Everyone can you know, admit to that. Q2, probably not as good. Q3 expectations are going to be worse. If consumer demand starts to fall, then I think that we will continue to see pain in the market, and we want to see the market shake out a little more in pain before we start making real investment opportunities.
The heritage of Rock Creek, when we meet with Afshani in Davos, is natural gas. She owns the high ground on the dynamics of gas and hydrocarbons as well. What is your response to the surge that they're living in continental Europe about natural gas? I mean, it's standard deviations out, isn't it?
The entire energy complex, we're in a different world, right? And there are a ton of investment opportunities, as you've heard from us before, in terms of the energy complex, in terms of natural gas, in terms of the tailwinds for renewable energy, wind, solar. There is so much that we can look at in terms of the next 5-10 years, and we're positioning our portfolios to take advantage of all of that. And unfortunately, Europe is going to take the pain in the interim.
You're advising. Rock Creek wanders into the White House today to meet with Amos and President Biden here. Here on LNG. Can you be optimistic that LNG can rescue Europe by December?
Not by December. I think that's a heavy task. I think that everything that is going on within Russia and Europe is going to dictate whether Europe comes out ahead at the end of the year. But I'll tell you, we're not, you know, bullish on Europe despite valuations, and it's because of the geopolitical tensions and the energy complex. How can you really be overweight Europe today?